long time to sort out the campers who are going to be in the science camp, and it is this group so far. And just like you see me pull out one, you may be here one day, and the next day you may not be. It's up to you. Everybody know that I'm Mrs. Ingram, and you know all of your teachers, you know. I give you now Sir Robert.
Hello?
Hi, forgive me. Hello, guys.
Hi.
Terrible. Can you say hello, sir?
Hello.
I want to change some realities for you today. Okay? First off, I want you to raise your hand if you think that you're strong. Ladies, you're not strong? Okay, that's fine. We'll be strong. All right, put your hands down. Let's go. All right, here's the reality. Most of you aren't strong, the ones that raised your hand. Now, I'm going to tell you why. Can you be strong? Say yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
What does it mean to be strong? Tell me. Oh, this guy first. You're in the front. So you know? Anybody know? You know? Strength. True strength is the ability to do what is right or what improves your life or the people around you. That's true strength. And it's hard. It's not easy to be strong. It's challenging.
Explain a little bit about our equipment. I'll let you guys take a guess. Do you know what we use for equipment? Anybody know?
Yeah.
Fire truck?
Yep, we have fire trucks. We got all kinds of shapes and sizes.
Yes, sir.
What we got?
Water?
Yeah, we use a lot of water.
Yes, sir.
Extinguishers sometimes?
Yeah.
What you got?
You got something?
No?
Well, we use all kinds of things.
Yes, sir.
Ladders?
Sometimes we might have to use ladders.
Primarily we use the bulldozer. You can put fire out in a couple different ways. Water. You can also take the fuel away from the fire, which would be the green stuff, the grass, the trees, the bushes. We use our bulldozer for that. We use airplanes. Airplanes help us basically find out where we need to go for the fire. We use helicopters. In South Florida, has anybody ever been down to the Everglades? Anybody visited there?
Yeah.
Down in the Everglades, we use airboats to fight fire. That's pretty interesting. We use different things, roll-a-don, which are giant buggies with tires on them. So we use all kinds of different things. That's what we use as for.
Energy is going green. Has anybody ever heard that? Do you know what it means?
Good for our economy, good for the environment, good for a lot of things. Creates new jobs. It's catching on quite a bit, and it's in my opinion a responsible and efficient way of creating energy. We always have to have energy. So this power plant was built in 2013, I've been working there for 2 years. I'm one of two foresters that work there. We handle the procurement, which is the gathering of wood that we burn to create energy. I'll go into that in a little more detail right now. Does anybody know what a renewable versus a non-renewable resource is?
A renewable resource is something that we grow right out of.
Okay.
And non-renewable is like coal or gas in the ground.
Well, bingo.
Mazza, Mr. Mazza, and I'm a paleontologist. Have you guys heard that before? Paleontologist is someone who studies ancient life, fossils, basically. And you may hear archaeology sometime. Archaeology is people who study ancient people, so they're kind of related. And Florida is mostly what I research and study and things like that. And there's actually a lot of fossils and a lot of things like that right here in Florida and in Vero and in Gifford. So there's some stuff that's all relevant to where you guys live. And what I want to do today and what I do is present these educational programs for like 10 years now. And I also do fossil hunting field trips. So I can take people out for the day to find fossils here in Florida. We find things like fossil shark teeth. We find mammoth, you saw the Ice Age, some of those animals. Mammoth, saber-toothed cats, and things like that. We sometimes find fossils of animals like that who used to live here before there were people really living around here. So I'm going to just talk about some of this stuff, and I'm going to show you some of the things, some of these real fossils, and then we're going to do a fossil hunting dig for some of them.
And so what we do at Missionary Flights International is we are able to use the airplanes that we have, their tools that God gives us, to honor and glorify God, and use that to bring missionaries back and forth to Haiti, Dominican Republic, and all these islands. We bring those missionaries, their supplies, and their teams. We have teams going all the time to Haiti. Matter of fact, you probably don't know this exactly, but on July 7th, Ethan, who's my son, and Grace, my daughter, my wife, and myself, we're going with 18 other people, and we're going to go to a small little place called Pion, Haiti, in the middle of Haiti, a little dirt airstrip. We're going to land in there. We're going to go work in an orphanage.
Sometimes, but not a lot. Well, it's just interesting. A lot of people who live in Indian River have some time at the end to go back down that month. But some questions and answers. First of all, is my endeavor for Columbia? Notice that the U.S. flag, the Japanese flag, you have a Japanese astronaut. Here we have an American flag, Japanese, Ukrainian, you have a Japanese astronaut, Ukrainian. So everything we do in space now is international. And the space station is called the International Space Station. That means we have people from 16 different countries participating in the space station.
Fish and their ecology, what they eat and all this other stuff. How many of you have been fishing? Oh, great. So, a number of you have been fishing. And you know, if all the grocery stores closed down, which you know, it might one of these days, we can go down to the end of Martin Luther King Boulevard here and we can get fish. And we're going to go down there today. And hopefully some of you get your feet wet. And we'll be collecting fish down there. Now, the lagoon down here is a little it's a little different from all the other estuaries in the United States. Estuaries are freshwater beach ocean. It has more kinds of fish than any other